Dear students, in this module, we will try to discuss and understand about the scientific method and its related issues, by which you will be able to know the following aspects: definition and meaning of the scientific method, characteristics of scientific method, steps in scientific method, importance of inductive and deductive logic in scientific method, difficulties in the use of scientific method to social sciences, and limitations of scientific method in social sciences. Friends, as you know, the scientific method, in a general way I am trying to give here first the picture. Science can be said as a systematic enterprise that builds and organizes knowledge in the form of testable explanations and predictions about the universe. The term method means an apt way of doing something. Every science employs scientific or experimental method for the study of its material. For instance, experimentation is possible in the case of natural sciences like physics, chemistry, etc. But in social sciences, pure experimental studies are difficult. On the other hand, in social sciences, systematic study of a phenomenon with observing, classifying, analyzing, giving explanations and trying to make generalizations and predictions is undertaken. In the words of Bernard, a scientific method may be defined in terms of its major process that takes place within it. These are testing, verification, definition, classification, organization, including prediction and application. According to Lundberg, another social scientist, scientific method is defined as the method which consists of the systematic observation, classification and interpretation of the data. According to Goldberg and Nato, the scientific method is a body of techniques for investigating phenomena, acquiring new knowledge or correcting and integrating previous knowledge. Taking these definitions into consideration, it can be said that in social sciences, the scientific method plays a vital role in terms of studying the social phenomena and human behavior in very systematic manner by obtaining empirical data, classifying the same accurately, testing the phenomena scientifically, and thereby drawing conclusions for generalization as well as prediction. Well, before understanding scientific method very well, we would like to focus upon characteristics of scientific method. First and foremost one in scientific method characteristics is the objectivity. The researcher should be impartial in studying the subject matter under consideration. In social sciences, maintaining objectivity is difficult, but many techniques have been developed so as to avoid subjectivity at different stages of research process. The second characteristics of scientific method is reliability. The information to be collected from the field about social life and human behavior should be reliable. For achieving high quality and most researchers used to follow the standardization procedures in developing data collection instruments and also during classification and analysis of the data. Third characteristics of scientific method is quantifiability. The information proposed to be collected and the propositions postulated should be quantifiable, that is, can be measured, expressible numerical terms and capable of being conducted. Such measurement should be very precise and comparable. Next characteristics is theoretical orientation. Science as a body of knowledge is characterized by orientation to the theory. The major objective of science is to find and produce a body of propositions that are logically and systematically interrelated in order to explain some broad category of phenomenon or theory, we can say. Next characteristics is verifiability. Scientific knowledge should be valid and thereby it should consist of propositions and that have been subjected to empirical tests, and that all the evidences must be based on observations of factual data. Whatever assertions to knowledge must refer to human experiences so that verification is possible. Another characteristic of scientific method is universality. Science is not concerned with the individual objects, but it is concerned with the different types, kinds, and classes of objectives. Therefore, researchers should make efforts to know and develop laws and theoretical propositions that are universally applicable. Next characteristic of scientific method is predictability. Any subject matter scientifically studied should be amenable to predictability, because of the reason that the nature of the most events and happenings occur in regularity intervals and similar basis. Having understanding about the characteristics of scientific method, we would like to proceed to know the steps in scientific method. First and foremost one is make an observation and raise questions. Scientists or researchers have the curiosity to study several phenomena in the world, and thereby with the scientific mind they develop the curiosity to study the phenomenon which is worth for investigation. Then scientifically the researchers will raise concern questions about something that they want to observe, like how, what, when, who, which, why, or where. Next step in scientific method is do background research and construct hypothesis. Generally, it is the responsibility of the researchers that would start from scratch in putting together a plan for answering the questions raised by them. Do review of literature, identify research gaps, and formulate objectives as well as hypothesis. Thirdly, conducting experiment and testing of hypothesis. In scientific method, collection of accurate and relevant data and are conducting carefully designed and controlled experiments like in natural sciences is an essential step for testing hypothesis with appropriate statistical tools and test of significance. The next step is classification and analysis of data. Well, the collected data related to a specific phenomenon has to be classified in a meaningful way, and then such data has to be analyzed taking into consideration of the hypothesis proposed. The data used to be analyzed with the frequency tables and cross tabulations with the suitable tests of significance as well as multivariate techniques, which would be mostly carried out making use of computers and user friendly and ready made programmed software. Interpretation and drawing conclusions and generalization in other step in the scientific method. After the analysis of data, researchers are expected to interpret the data in a lucid and scientific manner by supporting or disapproving the hypothesis and thereby providing an answer to the questions, that is objectives, under consideration. Based on the interpretation, one should draw generalizations which will lead to general laws or theory. Next step in the scientific method is communicating the results and verification. The results based on the scientific inquiry have to be communicated to the concerned stakeholders in the form of report, scientific papers, and or thesis, which also has to be done in a scientific manner. Likewise, scientific methods would not stop with the formulation of general laws or theory. These general laws or theoretical formulations have to be verified so as to test their validity over a period of time. Now, having understood the basics of scientific method, one of the major thing we have to understood is what is the logic and relation with the scientific method. Generally, logic is the science of reasoning. It formulates the conditions through which the validity of reasoning may be tested. Reasoning consists of arriving of a conclusion from certain premises and is called inference, which is nothing but derived knowledge which consists of assertion or propositions. For ascertaining a valid conclusion, the science should depend on logical method. Based on the logic of reasoning, two scientific approaches, namely inductive logic and deductive logic, are used. The first one is inductive logic. In the case of inductive logic, it is a process where we observe certain phenomena and on that basis arrive at conclusions. In induction, we logically establish a general proposition based on the observed facts. Sometimes it is called as bottom-up approach. In this method, one makes a set of observations and seeks to explain what one senses. For example, it is observed that 5 women like A, B, C, D and E in a sample village have 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 children respectively. From these observations, one can conclude that in the selected village, women are providing large number of children. When it comes to deductive logic is the process by which we arrive at a reasoned conclusion by logical generalization of a known fact. In deduction, we logically establish the facts based on general propositions. Deductive reasoning works from the more general to the more specific. It is also called as top-down approach. We might begin with thinking of a theory, then narrow down to specific hypotheses to be tested, and then narrow down further what we collect observations to address the hypothesis. This usually leads us to test the hypothesis with the exact data, that is, a continuation of or not of our original theories. Based on the example cited earlier, it is general observation, that is the truth, that women in the sample village are having large number of children, and therefore, suppose a woman F and G are also in the same village or same society, they are also likely to have more number of children. Having understanding the intricacies of a scientific method, we will try to see what are the difficulties in the use of scientific method to social sciences. The first and foremost one is human behavior as well as social phenomenon are complex as well as varied across and within societies and cultures. Hence, it is very difficult to study the same with the scientific approach. Secondly, social sciences researchers, mostly study and analyze the social life and human behavior of other human beings, and thereby personal characteristics of researchers come into the picture and distort the facts or leads to subjectivity. Thirdly, the third difficulty is likely to be most aspects of social life, social relations and human behavior are qualitative in nature, which are not stringently amenable for quantitative measurement. Next one is about human behavior is not uniform and predictable, and it is more often uncertain. All people may not behave or act in the same way in similar circumstances, or one individual may behave differently under similar circumstances. In view of this, studying human behavior at times becomes difficult. Another difficulty we will face is application of experimental method to study human behavior will be very much difficult, and thereby the collection of reliable and scientific data cannot always be collected. Having understanding the scientific method difficulties, what are the limitations or drawbacks of scientific method in social sciences? First and foremost one is the scientific method involves abstraction, that is based on facts. Secondly, scientific explanation is never complete. At every stage, there are some basic principles which remain unexplained in social sciences. The conclusions arrived at by scientific method are not final. They are only relative to observed phenomenon, facts discovered and reasoning developed. Social sciences have limited scope. Each science is concerned with a particular area and is limited in certain assumptions. The next limitation is superstitions, cherished beliefs, etc., are hostile to the growth of scientific method. Institutions, authoritarians and functionists and mystics often underline the respect for scientific method. The next limitation is formal procedures are fruitless. Definitions and formal distinctions are not yet often used properly, and statistical information may be irrelevant and inconclusive. Scientific judgment is difficult and sometimes impossible when solutions demand immediate action. Next one limitation is growth of scientific method in a society where there is no desire for truth or freedom for the expression, intellectual doubts is surely hampered. The necessary time for the reflection and material for experiments are often lacking for the proper development of scientific method. The next limitation is scientific researchers in social field are often in the hands of those who cannot always oppose the established opinions or taboos. Lastly, no scientific method can guarantee certainty of achieving the goal. In spite of these limitations, there is no disagreement that scientific method is the only way to increase the general body of tested knowledge and to eliminate arbitrary and ambiguous opinions. As researchers are becoming more and more aware about different aspects of scientific methods, in the recent past, it has become possible for them to predict social events with greater accuracy. In sum, in this module, a detailed discussion is made about the fundamentals of scientific method and its application to social sciences, focusing on scientific method, definition and meaning, characteristics of scientific method, steps in scientific method, importance of inductive and deductive logic, and difficulties in use of scientific method in social sciences, and finally, limitations of scientific method in social sciences. Hope you will understand in greater detail. Thank you.